My name is Eltigani Abdelgalil. My colleague Mohamed Gali is from, we are from University of Gezira. Mohamed Gali is economist and water management specialist. So as you may know, Sudan is an agriculture-based country, and agriculture contributes a lot in providing raw materials, and local industries account for 30% to 40% of export earnings and provide income and employment of major group of the population. However, agriculture consumes a lot of water. And unfortunately, so far, water in Sudan treated just an engineering issue, just to supply water. For what purpose? No one evaluate the water in the field and the returns from using water. And there is a competition on water. I'm trying to evaluate or to put value for water used in agriculture, as agriculture is the biggest consumptive water in the world, and particularly in Sudan. In Sudan, we have Gezira irrigated scheme, is the largest irrigated scheme worldwide. Gash area, we have so many small pumping schemes along the Nile, and agriculture consumes about 95% of our available water in Sudan. Therefore, it is very important to evaluate this water or to put a certain value to our exact value, the water, to encourage farmers use it efficiently or wisely. Therefore, the aim of this paper is to determine the value used in agriculture. I want to put value because policymakers asking about the value of water and the cost of water so that they collect the exact value from farmers or from users. Why I'm thinking into evaluate or to put an economic value to the water, because this statement, water should be treated as an economic good, is very stated in so many international conferences. For example, the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development held in Rio de Janeiro, and the World Summit on Water Sustainable Development in Johannesburg, and Freshwater Resources Forum. It is stated very clearly that water should be treated as an economic good. And another reason is that valuation of water is one way of making users more aware about its value. Unfortunately, so far, farmers treated water just like a free. Decision makers also need to know the exact value of water to make corrective decisions when they are investing in water. So many problems in irrigated schemes. For example, there is a lot of money spent annually on operation and maintenance without significant progress in the output, particularly in Gezira scheme. Recovery of operation and maintenance cost and other irrigation services cost are very low. There is a huge losses of water, cut out of growing areas. There is an accumulation of silt annually. There is a problem of productivity, low productivity. Also, there is the problem of water-associated diseases. All these problems, unfortunately, comes from low value of water. It is not an engineering problem, as others imagine. It is because no value of water. People treated water just like free gift. Therefore, all this problem just because of no real value of water. As I remember, there is a big workshop about Gezira scheme in Sudan. When I raised my hand and said, water treated like free, there is no value of water, some of the biggest members of the organizers said to me, you are still young to speak about Gezira. The methodology, in the methodology I visited Gezira scheme or meet with the users or farmers. Also I visited Gash agriculture scheme and Gadarif area here. I used Gezira scheme because Gezira scheme is gravity irrigation scheme, controlled water. Flood irrigated scheme in Gash, different irrigation systems. And in Gadarif, there is no irrigation. It is pure rain-fed agriculture. This is to exactly evaluate the water. Then I sit with farmers. I question them about their agricultural output and how much water they used. Also, I used climate and crop models to estimate the water delivered for irrigation. These models are developed by FAO. Also, economic net return was estimated using net value from agriculture as the net value of agriculture equal gross value minus cost of cultivation. A value of water equal to net value of water with irrigation minus net value of water without irrigation over volume of water delivered for irrigation. The results, these are the results. These are the blue one is the water required for sorghum in Gezira, for example. In Gash agriculture scheme, respect irrigation, and in Gadarif rain-fed irrigation scheme, the water required minus effective rainfall, this give us the irrigation required. The volume of water or irrigation required in Gezira like this annually or per fadan, per hectare, and this is for in Gash respect irrigation scheme in hectare. This is the net value of agriculture in gravity system in Gezira also, and spate irrigation system, and this is without irrigation system in rain-fed or in Gadarif area. Actually, I update this presentation, but unfortunately, Profamulam, this is the old one. No problem. With a few in animations. Finally, I calculated the net value of water like this. The value of water in gravity irrigation system is about 0.005 US dollar per hectare or per meter cube, and in spit irrigation, 0.001 dollar per meter cube. In gravity irrigation system like Gezira, because the cost is high, this is controlled water, and in Gash, just flood water. This is because why the value is less than in gravity system. Generally, the value of water in Sudan is below the global range of 0.01 US dollar per meter cube to $2 per meter cube. And this has created a big problem. Some of the World Bank mission visited us at the University of Gezira and says that we need to use the 6 milliard used in Gezira scheme annually elsewhere, because this is waste of water. If this value, this is waste of water. This is why the big problems, our big problems in irrigated agriculture is the value of water. We give water free for users. Finally, the value of water used in agriculture is relatively low compared with the global range. Low productivity and high cost are behind the low value of water in the agriculture sector. To put the real value of water in agriculture as the major consumptive sector will help into setting real value and cost of water, and hence policymakers will take corrective decisions on irrigated agriculture. And thank you.